Hey, it's Dave here once again. Today I'm working on this EdenPURE quartz infrared portable heater. Now, I'm debating on whether or not these things are worth the money people are paying for them, because this one here is only 2 years old and it's already crapped out. So the guy who brought this to me told me that it no longer gets hot, so which I tend to believe, because it is not working. So there's six lamps inside this. Here's two of them here, these two, and then there's another two here. And there's another one that's supposed to be mounted in here, which I've got removed right now. And then the other one is right here in the front. He contacted the factory, and they told him that they would send him another transformer, which doesn't seem to really help out much. Anyways, I've removed the bracket that goes in here. Okay, and it holds a lamp, or what I thought would be a lamp. Since it says it's a quartz thing, I'm not sure why they would say it's quartz, but basically this is one of the heater elements right here. And bingo, here's what's wrong with it. You know, I don't think they're actually quartz, because inside that looks like a tungsten heater inside a tube, if you ask me. So how they're able to say that this is a quartz heater is beyond me. But as you can see, the heater element has broken, okay? And there's six elements in this, and out of the six, three of them are defective. So that's why it doesn't work anymore. So, you know, they're really garbage, I think. But if you look, just for reference, this is where the wiring is and stuff, how it's wired up. And what I'm going to do is just rotate it around here so you can see the other side. But if you're ever considering buying one of these, I would not, okay? Because of the fact that this one didn't run for very long. So here's the other side. And the other wiring harness, and you can see where it goes to all the elements. There's three elements there. Of course, I got one out right now, so you're not going to see it, but there's another two here, and then the one I've got out is up the top here. Okay, so in the back of this unit is a blower fan, which is right here, and that fan does not come on. Okay, and what they do is the air comes in through this duct at the back, which is supposed to have a filter on it. Okay, the temperature sensor is right here in behind the plastic. Okay, and then there's a thermal switch or a thermal cutoff device up here that shuts everything off if it gets too hot. Now, this is what the front of it looks like, and I've got the circuit board out of it. So, but the blower, which is the next point I was going to make, the blower basically blows air into the cavity area here, okay, and then the air gets into it by going into these chambers where the heating elements are. And then in the back of the chamber, back in there, is another opening that allows the air to make its way out to this front grill here, which you may not be able to see very well, but that's where the actual heat comes out of. So, but anyways, there's the front panel, and the unit comes with a remote control, which is here. All the remote and all the LEDs and the panel, all the buttons and everything seem to work. but the fan doesn't come on. And like I was saying, I don't understand if it says that it's a quartz here, quartz infrared here, which is what it says on the back here, how they can call that kind of a device, because here's what's inside each of the heating elements. So anyways, out of the six heating elements in this one, okay, three of them are burnt out. And if you check with the wiring diagram, which is right here on the top, basically these three here are all burnt out. So the power comes in, goes through this, and then out through that to the circuit board. So there's like three different heating elements, okay, and three of them are burnt out. And this is how the unit came in. There was absolutely no dust inside here. So it's not like it's, you know, gotten really dusty because somebody had the back cover off, because there's no dust in the fan, very little dust. And like I said, this thing's only 2 years old. It was made at 2008. So if you're thinking of spending the money on one of these, I wouldn't recommend it. Now to find out how much those three heating elements are. It's probably going to be quite a bit of money. But anyways, there's a good look on the inside if you want to use it for any reference. They seem to have thought this little transformer here was gone and got the lady to buy another transformer and ship it up, but unfortunately that didn't fix it. And these are made in Ohio by Yulong Productions or something like that. Yulong Industrial Company Limited. So, as I said, I wouldn't waste the money on one of these. Especially if it's only going to last a year to 2 years and then stop working. And you can clearly see what happened to this, okay? The element itself has burned out, okay? You can see that. There's a little blob on either end where the element itself became molten and just fell apart. So, I would have thought that being a quartz infrared heater, that they would have used a quartz light bulb inside there. But that's only my opinion. I don't know why they didn't. So, anyways, there you go. Thanks for watching.